sitting here at our Cancer Caregiver Conference, the first one in almost 3 years, and it's really about getting people together so we can share our experiences, but also get information and resources. And, you know, this morning we've been devoted to triage cancers, you know, about all the different Medicare and all the different insurance issues. But I wanted to introduce yourself and say just your first name, because this is my family, the England family. So introduce yourself and who you are. Okay.
Right.
I'm
Keith Ingram.
Keith needs to be around here a little bit, I think. I just wanted to make sure.
I'm picking him, doing him up off this camera here.
Okay, I'm talking to the expert, Bob. Anyway, Bob, good. But anyway, what is important, though, is that...
You start by.
So, Pat, I think we should start with you because you're the designated patient. Good thing.
Our journey started in 2010 when I was diagnosed. Our journey started in 2010 when I was diagnosed with multiple myeloma, and I actually knew what it was because my next door neighbor had succumbed to it in 2002. So I was fortunate. Also did a lot of research, and unfortunately had Barbara and Jack early on in the journey, and the Mayo Clinic found a lot of practices too, so knowledge is power. The more you can learn about it, the more you can make informed decisions. Yeah.
That's a really good word, informed decisions, because very often with cancer, people don't feel they have a decision or a choice. And I think that was really one of the really important aspects of what we tried to do as, you know, cancer patient, a cancer caregiver in our organization, was say to people, you have a right to ask questions. So again, you know, Keith, I think for you as the husband, you know, for you, what was, you know, kind of for you the kind of experience in terms of here's your wife and she has this cancer?
Well, I think for me, I had to take over doing all the cooking, mainly, and doing a lot of the housework and stuff that, that she couldn't do.
So, no one was the difference in roles. It was that suddenly you're kind of in a situation where you can't even think about, you know, you or your life or what you're doing, but trying to, you know, be, you know, helpful. I know that if, you know, I were the one that wasn't able to function, we wouldn't be eating and there would be no cleaning because Jack doesn't do that. And so what I'm saying is for some people, it's not just a change in roles, but it's totally, you know, difficult because they don't feel confident in that. So again, good for you, but at the same time, it's very hard because you have your own health issues.
Yes, I do.
Yeah. I think you need to mention that because, you know, it's not always this kind of neat, like, I'm the patient, you're the caregiver. It's like, right?
Yes. I was battling Parkinson's disease and I also got some heart issues. Trying to keep under control, and I'm also a type 2 diabetic, which I've been trying to keep under control. My last A1C was 6.1, from the previous one was 6.4, and the one before that was 6.5. So I'm coming down to where it's under control, more or less.
And again, that takes a whole nother level of, you know, not only care, but, you know, food and stress, all the things that, you know, we go into it. And you're also a veteran.
Yeah.
And I think that's important also. It's not talked about enough because the focus is often on not just the disease, but also in terms of your own life experience. And I think, again, it's important to acknowledge that. And again, you're, you know, one of three brothers. So I remember when we met, it seemed to be that everybody was trying to help, which meant that nobody was helping. But everybody was trying to do the right thing, but it was really hard because you have obviously different skills and they have different skills and so on. So how about for you? Because it really seemed to be a lot of people kind of taking charge of it.
That's what we hope, because the more you're able to take care of you and
their health issues, the better we all are. So,
I think the whole thing you're saying, we're all in it together, is important. A few months ago, a friend of mine.
Come here, Jack.
She was actually a nurse herself, and she texted me and called me right away. It's her cousin, a couple hours away.
I'm going to take a break and let Jack, because this is very important. I also have several jobs.